We're coming down from a solar storm from some fast solar wind, just in time to get ready for another one. That story and more in the shorty this week. Space weather this week has gotten very exciting. We had some fast wind from a corona hole that had rotated into the Earth's strike zone, but it sent us the storm almost a day late. Nonetheless, it was worth the wait because it bumped us up to G2 storm levels and brought Aurora clear down to Wyoming. Meanwhile, we've kind of been taking some time to settle down. We're at unsettled conditions now, but it's not going to last for long because we have yet another coronal hole that's going to be rotating into the Earth's strike zone. And just like the last one, this one is also a repeat offender, but this time this coronal hole has grown into some weird kind of shape here. It looks a little bit like a horseshoe or maybe an H. You tell me what it looks like, but because of its strange shape, it may actually give us a 1-2 punch with some couple bursts of fast wind, and that could bump us up to storm levels starting around late on the 9th, most likely into the 10th, and possibly with the second punch hitting even on the 11th. Now, I'm not expecting this storm to be nearly as strong as the other one. I don't expect G2 storm levels, but it could give us some decent aurora show yet again. Switching to our solar storm conditions and aurora possibilities over the coming week, we are anticipating the hit from that fast wind from that corona hole that's going to be rotating into the Earth's strike zone. At high latitudes, we're expecting at least minor storm conditions with even about a 60% chance of a major storm starting around the 9th to the 10th. It's kind of hard to say because this corona hole is shaped so strangely. If we get it a 1-2 punch, we might even get storming conditions lasting in through the 11th before things begin to calm down, especially at high latitudes. Now, at mid-latitudes, we're only expecting active conditions, but we've got a decent chance for minor storm conditions to hit. And again, this may linger until about Sunday and into Monday before things really begin to calm down. It's hard to tell, but we're not expecting nearly the strength of the storm that we had just less than a week ago, but it should still be enough to give us some decent aurora, possibly down to mid-latitudes. Switching to your solar flare and particle radiation storm outlook over the coming week, everything is still in the green when it comes to solar flares. We have a spotless sun right now, and this means good news for you GPS users. You should have great GPS reception on Earth's day side. Now, we do have a region that is rotating into Earth view off of the sun's east limb. It's pretty dim right now, and I don't know if it's going to get a number designated by NOAA, but it is upping the solar flex just a little bit. We are back into the 70s for solar flux, which means marginal radio propagation for you shortwave responders and amateur radio operators. This is wonderful news. I've been hearing some good communication on 10 meters and 20 meters, by the way, this past week. So this should boost it up just a little bit more. And these conditions should last easily over the next few days, possibly over the next week. Now, because we are at solar minimum, we are getting a higher penetration of cosmic rays than we normally would. So you frequent flyers, and this does include the air crew who fly more than 800 hours annually and who fly at high latitudes and high altitudes, you are in the marginal range for radiation dose right now, and this does include the prenatal passengers. So please take this into consideration in your flight plans. So the space weather this week is extremely exciting. We just came down from a moderate level solar storm that brought Aurora clear down to Wyoming, and we're gearing up for yet another storm. Now, this coming solar storm probably won't be as strong as the one we just had, but it could be enough to bump us back up to storm levels starting late on the 9th, most likely into the 10th, and possibly lingering into the 11th before things begin to settle down a little bit. It's hard to tell with this very strange shape of a coronal hole we're getting. So you aurora photographers, keep your batteries charged because we might even get some shows briefly at mid-latitudes. Now, you amateur radio and shortwave radio operators, well, you guys should be pretty happy. We're back into the marginal range for radio propagation, and this could easily last for the next week, and we have that bright region that's rotating into Earth view. So who knows, this may even last almost 2 weeks before things begin to tank again. And then as far as you GPS users are concerned, well, you know, things on the Earth's day side look really good. The reception should be very clean. And then on Earth's night side, well, as long as you stay away from the aurora during the solar storm on the 9th through the 11th, and as long as you stay away from those dawn dust terminators that are always a bit tricky, your GPS reception should be pretty nice. I'm Tamitha Scove. Thank you for watching.